This is a psychic development reading for Selah, and as usual, I'm going to start by surrounding myself in light. Yeah, now I'm going to see you surrounded in light also. Okay, so as I'm seeing you surrounded in the light, the first thing that's coming up is your guides are showing me these gems going down your spine. And so these are symbolizing different chakras. And it's all down the spine region, and then they're all coming this way with the energy going out around the sides of your back in this way. And so these are putting energy through your whole body, and part of this has to do with the nervous system as well. And so they're saying that it has to do with emotions. They're also saying emotional up and downs. But the back, this has to do with your support. And one of the things that's coming up is family support. And your guide is showing me. That in some ways, when you were a kid, it's like you were a comfort to yourself. You were. You're very joyful, naturally. That's one of the things coming through. And you have this ability to comfort others, but especially when you were a kid, it's coming through that you were attempting to comfort yourself. And also that you were wise beyond your years. And there's this sense that sometimes you're kind of in your own world, kind of focused inward and focused on yourself. And even in some ways, to almost repel certain external things happening around you that you don't like to see, or that you don't like to be a part of or have expressed around you, or energies that you don't like to have coming towards you. So some of the energies in the childhood they're showing me were kind of unstable. And so they're pointing to the back again. So the back, it has to do with different types of support, and a lot of times it can have to do with family support. So they're kind of tapping these gems on your back. So these chakras, I'll just say chakras. They're kind of tapping these chakras on your back. Now this also shows a bit more development since you have several that are activated here. And as you might know from some of my videos, I'm not sure if I've gotten into this much or not, but the council teaches about different chakras, that there are not just 7 or just 13, that there are a lot more chakras that people actually have, and that you can't really just contain them to the body. Like, you have a stomach, so you have one in your stomach, you have one in your lower stomach, and one in your upper stomach, and one here and one there. There are a lot more than just those few. But when a person becomes more awakened and more activated, they need more of these chakras to activate. More of them begin to develop. More of them begin to turn on. So this does show me more advancement spiritually, since you already have more of these that are turning on. And they are tapping these with some kind of tool. It's almost like they're chipping away at something, like they're honing something, but also primarily that they're almost getting something off of it. They're cleansing something off of it. But there's also this feeling again that you taught yourself, and that you supported yourself, and through your adulthood you stepped into your own power more, and you did some of the things, a lot of the things for yourself that weren't necessarily done for you as a kid. So there were some things that you had to learn on your own or do on your own that just weren't available to you as a kid from an outside source. But I also see you kind of in your head, like you are almost speaking with imaginary friends or speaking with guides and this kind of thing when you were a kid. And getting kind of your own, like, entertainment from your own imaginings that are going on in your own mind. And this is an area where actually you were developed, where a lot of your gifts were developing and were developed. And so in this area, in this way, they would come out. Now, as an adult, we tend to shut this down, especially if they're coming out in this kind of way. When we grow up, we tend to shut those types of areas down because they are not adult. They are not things that adults do. They are things that children do only. And when you are an adult, you are supposed to put the lid on that. I've even heard before from a spiritual practitioner that I went to some years back, that they're reminding me of now. She was telling me some years ago that children come in with their crown chakras wide, wide, wide open. And then as they become adults, they close. This chakra closes. But this is the chakra that allows for you to communicate with your guides and to receive divine messages and divine information and inspiration. So some of it has to do with creativity too, being divinely inspired. It's not only like channeling or speaking to a guide in this way, like mediumship or something, but it can simply be messages given in a wide variety of areas, and not necessarily to other people, but also to yourself. Because psychic abilities, you know, it's not just for reading other people. A lot of it has to do with guiding your own life and your own self and taking care of yourself. And that's what your guides are really pointing out here. That's where you've really honed those abilities. Your intuition has set up your life. It's helped you to coordinate things that you wouldn't have thought of, and express things that you felt where you were trapped. It gave you outlets to express them. So a lot of this has been for yourself, to take care of yourself and help yourself along the way. Not all for other people. Okay. Okay. They are directing me to my cards, so I'm going to go ahead and pull one of these. I have my lovely crystal here on my lap. I'm going to go ahead and set you down. Beautiful person. And take these out. Okay, and what your guide is saying is how can you hone this ability for what you need to do now? That's what he wants to talk to you about. Okay, but another ability, this actually was coming up earlier in the reading too, and the readings go so fast, I don't always get to everything. Whoa. I don't know how well you can see that, but this one is the fairy who was kissed by the pixies. And this is another ability that you have. I think I did get some of this. I think I did say some of this earlier in the reading. Because you have this ability to comfort others and encourage others and to like uplift spirits. And so this card is very much about letting go and about expanding, about heart expansion. And so they're saying that you have a very developed heart chakra. And some of this came to you because of the childhood, because of some things that were done to you in your childhood or happened to you in your childhood, or also just support that was lacking from your childhood. Okay. Okay, and this card, my lighting is not so good right now. That's because I set it up. Wolf didn't. He's the one that does all the lighting and everything. And he does a very good job with that. But this guy is called Gotcha. So again, they're just saying that he's like the tower card in Tarot. I don't know if you're familiar with that, where all the people are jumping out of the building and there's the earthquake and the tower is kind of tumbling. And this is an Oracle deck, obviously. It's not Tarot, but he is like the tower card for me. So there was some instability. Again, they're speaking about instability in the childhood. And then this card is coming up, the friends. But I'm gonna pull one more card with that. Okay, and this is the Singer of Connection coming up with the Friends card. So you had this instability and this kind of turmoil around you, and some connections that were kind of lacking, or support that was in some ways lacking. It's not that you had no one around you physically that you could connect with. There's that feeling as well. So it was not everyone. There are some people that you did connect with in the physical, but these cards are specifically saying that because of connections that were lacking in the physical, you went inside of yourself and you pulled from yourself in a lot of ways, and you became very adult. So there was a lot that you had to take on as a kid, a lot that you had to endure, and you went into yourself, and your guides are applauding you for that. That you took the time to nurture yourself and to honor yourself. So you remembered who you were. You remembered that you are special, you are unique, you are a gift. Okay, so let's move forward now. More water. Forward in time now, so coming bit out of childhood. Oops. Okay, the guardian at the gate. Okay, I want to pull another card with this. Okay, I'm just going to pull another card with this and then I'll say what I'm doing. One might have fallen out, kind of knocked against me though, and fell back in. That's too many. These are jumping around a lot. Okay, so and this one is soulless. Both of these cards have a lot of energy with them. This card is especially about the solar plexus, but your guides here are really speaking about the heart chakra. They keep impressing me with that, with the heart chakra, and about expanding and this emotional expansion, healing that they're coming in with. Now also, the throat, also the throat chakra, and your ability to express things and to teach things. And they're also saying on developing minds around you. So you have the ability to what's the word I'm looking for? To impress things upon the younger generations around you, the younger minds around you. And also a teaching ability as well. And the fact that what you say comes from your heart, and the things that you do carry an impact. They carry an energy with them because they come from your heart. When it's centered in this way, you are really impacting things even that you're not aware of. They're also saying that you're heard. They're showing me hands together like this, so almost like prayers or intentions. They're saying that you're being heard, that they're uplifting you, and that they are teaching you, and they're coming around you. And it's like any inabilities that you have, they're pushing them down, they're pushing them away. These abilities are coming to the forefront. These abilities to guide and to teach others. Because one of the things that's really coming up here is like a counseling ability, an ability to speak to others and almost offer like therapy or healing and guidance and upliftment. So they're saying that you are a guide and you are a teacher, and that this comes out in a lot of ways. And some of this is because of what happened in the childhood. So they're saying that that wasn't for nothing. You didn't just have those experiences just to bash you down. You actually lifted yourself out of it. You weren't a victim to it. You didn't fall prey to it. You actually rose to the occasion. And you did what you needed to do to stay in your energy and keep your energy intact. And so that's another thing that they're saying, is that your energy is very much intact. But right now, this expansion is happening faster. It's happening faster, and you're learning a lot faster. There's a lot of movement. And they're saying spiritually, and they're saying emotionally, and they're saying as far as healing. They're also showing me cords, that there are a lot of cords that are being broken and a lot of things that are being undone. So you are removing a lot of things right now, but they're also kind of going like this. Some of this you aren't really aware of, because this is happening energetically. Physically, some of this you will see later on. And right now they are, they're showing me therapy, like almost like hypnosis and this kind of thing, like a spiritual type of therapy, like hypnosis or something in this type of field, where you are giving some type of spiritual therapy. One of the things I'm being impressed with is to even go to some types of spiritual therapy like this, that right now would be a good time for that kind of thing. And they're showing me different things. They're showing me to focus on healing yourself right now, even with like flower essences and things like this. They're showing me music, anything that will uplift you. Because right now you are releasing a lot of karmic things, and you're also releasing a lot of things from this lifetime. So they're saying that right now is a really good time for you. Oh, and part of it they're saying is about the new year. It being the new year and this new year, that you are releasing a lot of things this year, and more in the beginning of this year, that this is a transitional time for you right now, energetically and emotionally speaking. So they're saying that you should take advantage of the energies that are coming to you, and that you can be doing therapy and with some other spiritual people. But then the other thing that is kind of coming up is that you definitely have gifts in this area. You have gifts, like I said, with counseling and with understanding others, because of some of the things that you have been through, not only in this life but in past lives. And some of this is positive as well. How you went into yourself, how you sustained yourself in this lifetime, and also the things that you knew. Some of the things that you knew growing up innately came from past lifetimes. Especially one particular past lifetime. Gosh, at the beginning of the reading, they were showing me a necklace around your neck, and they were showing me like a blue gem in it, and they were saying blue star, and I didn't really know what that meant, and so I kind of moved on, and I figured, you know, if they wanted to bring it up again, they would, and they would explain it more. But I think that this has to do with the lifetime that I kind of vaguely, or I don't really remember the last reading that we did, because I don't normally remember the readings that well afterwards, especially not after a little bit of time has passed. But they're saying that a lot of the things that you innately knew came from that previous lifetime, from your home planet, they're saying. But again, this thing of speaking and almost of being a leader, almost like a political leader, is the energy that they're coming in with. And so like speaking engagements and things like this, where there's this energy, like, you know how to conduct yourself and you know how to come across and you know how to uplift people or encourage people. But also in this lifetime, you know how to move an audience, you know how to stir people. And you have presence, But they're saying that a lot of the abilities that you came in with and things that you innately knew came from this lifetime, where you were really a leader. You were a leader for a lot of people. Okay, yeah, and they're, one of the things that is coming through again that I'm remembering from the other reading was this energy of like a ruling class. I'm about to run out of water soon, and we're only halfway through the reading. Okay, I think I have some more water in this room, though, so that's good. Okay. Okay, right, yeah, but that was one of the other things coming through, was also, have you ever thought about giving this a kind of therapy like this? Have you ever thought about actually learning to give a hypnosis session or do some kind of grounding, like almost releasement type of work with a person where they are remembering past lives perhaps, or childhood memories? That would be more like hypnosis. Or where they are releasing energies out of themselves, which doesn't have to be hypnosis, that can be other things, but falling in this spiritual category, that's something that is coming up that would almost be an alternative thing that you could do, that you would have a natural gift for and be able to do very well. And they're also showing me, someone lying down and they have crystals on their back, and you're like massaging them or even doing Reiki, things like this with your hands, where you're touching the person. And so this is a very healing energy, and the crystals are very grounding, and they're very healing and cleansing. And, you know, some of this could also be almost like a symbol, these crystals on the back, because even at the beginning they were showing me the crystals on your back and it was representing your chakras. But on the other hand, there is, you know, actual therapy. There are people who do energy work with stones being placed on a person's back. So they're just saying that this is something to think about. This would be something that you could learn how to do, and that you would have, you would easily have a knack for, especially if it's in the area of counseling, teaching, advising, and helping a person through something. And again, some of this they're saying comes from the childhood. That, again, they're saying that this wasn't for no reason, that you learned a lot of things out of that that have actually really helped you move forward now. But they're also saying that there's no specific area where it's like you must move in this direction. They're saying that there are several areas that you could go into, and it's more like what would you want to do? What would bring you joy? And stepping out of anything that does not bring you joy, and it is and is not in alignment with the kind of healing and therapy in a sense that you are going through now, or that you're going to be going through. Because they're sending you energies right now to support that upliftment, and also upliftment of a lot of negative energies too. So like surfacing of a lot of things that are going to release. So they're saying that there might be some negative side effects from that as well. Like there could be, crying or even some physical symptoms perhaps. But they're saying to remember that you will just be releasing things. But they're saying again though, they're advising you to go to some kind of session or people who help with this, because they're saying actively, like you need to take advantage of the energy, and you need to actively do something that's going to help you to remove this. Another thing that they're showing me was that when you were a kid, you were quite psychically aware with like spirits and different things, and that you would get afraid a lot of nights. And also that you kind of blocked that out as well, but they're acknowledging that too. They're saying that that's there too, like, do you ever feel a presence behind you? Or do you feel like someone is watching you or someone else is in the room with you? That's odd. Now they're also saying, do you ever get like a feeling of anxiety, like out of nowhere? But normally I would think of that as empathy with other people, other physical people, but they're actually showing me a picture of like spirits. So sometimes you are actually picking up even on a spirit empathically, they're saying. So they're saying that sometimes that's something to watch out for if you ever feel almost imbalanced, just out of nowhere. Or you even get just like thoughts suddenly just racing through your head out of nowhere, and you don't really know why. Then this means that something is imbalanced around you. So you are psychically sensitive, they're saying. Okay, the topsy turvets. What they're saying is that things are very much in flux for you right now, and things are really shifting for you right now. Now, I'm also They're also sending a feeling of like a career or a job shift. And there's a feeling almost like that needs to happen. Like perhaps you are not exactly happy with where you are in that area, like in the way of finances. How you are making ends meet right now, how you are making your money right now, and how it's coming to you. So they're saying that you want to expand that's something that they would want you to do, because they're saying that there are other areas where you would be happier. They're also saying there are other areas where you would be more successful, and they're also saying there are other areas where you would be freer and where you would be more independent. Because they're saying that this is too structured. And they're saying that you like to be the leader of your own life. Not have somebody bossing you around at all, or have another energy influencing you in your area. So they're saying that once you come into your own area where you are valuable, where your opinion is really worthy of being taken seriously, then you're really going to shine. You're really going to come into your own. You're going to come more into your own place. And then you're going to start putting out more of an energy that will feed others, because they're also sending this energy. It's like one of the reasons that you came here was to be stationed just as yourself, as who you are, where you kind of spill out this energy. That really helps other people just by being yourself and being who you are and encouraging others by what you say. But if you don't feel free to be who you are or to speak freely and authentically, then you're not really doing your purpose, and you're not really benefiting the people around you, the others around you, like you would really want to, and like you're stationed here to do, because that's part of it, they're saying. They're saying that part of it is lessons to be learned, and that's why you're here. But part of it is also things that you want to accomplish. Energetically, with energies that you want to put out and sway. What do you mean by that? Energies that you want to balance out, but in other people as well, they're saying. To help other people to heal and come more into alignment, they're saying, because, you know, with all the with this negative charge of energy that is around the planet, people just get kind of screwed up and topsy-turvy, they're saying. Okay. And so you're also here to balance that, to help people come more into alignment and balance that out. Another thing that they're bringing up is they're bringing up Archangel Michael, and he's very good at that. And they're also showing me his crystal sword, because they have been showing a lot of crystals, and they're reminding me the cords that they were showing me before in the reading, that there are a lot of cords that you're breaking through right now. So they're also saying that it would be good to do some guided meditations with Archangel Michael and to remove more of these cords and things. And they're specifically saying to parents, they're also saying grandparents as well, that some of it's generational. And I'm also getting siblings. A cord to a sibling or to siblings. Okay, they're also showing me, they're showing me your third eye, and there's this sense almost like of trauma or like a shock or being impacted in a really negative way or a harmful way and getting a bit scared by it and closing down. So this could be trauma that like a specific trauma that happened in your lifetime, which would most likely be in your childhood, or this could also just be the overwhelming feeling of kind of being dropped here and being on Earth. It could also be both, actually. It could be both of those things, but I'm seeing that your third eye, it's almost like it was damaged or partially closed by this. You didn't want it to be open. I feel like you were very sensitive as a kid and you didn't want to feel everything. You didn't want to see everything. You didn't want to be so sensitive. Okay. Okay, the Piper. All right, and what they're kind of showing me is that you would kind of tiptoe through things. You didn't want to disturb anything or affect anything, not only in a negative or harmful way, but it's also that you didn't really want to be noticed. You didn't really want to be heard. But they're saying that now it's the time to be heard and to come into your own. Okay, him I'm going to put back. How many am I supposed to take? They're all falling out of the deck. Okay, I'm gonna try this one more time. Okay, Lasguna and Indy. Let me see. God, this lighting. Did the worst job with this lighting. Okay. Okay, well, Indy is about a decision that you are making or have to make, or they're kind of sending should make. And again, I feel like it's the career. And then Lasguna is all about going in different avenues, trying different things. and doing what she loves the most. Putting your energy and your attention and focus on what will make you happy and what will bring you into alignment with who you are is what will make you happy. So they're saying that your happiness has to come first right now. And they're also saying that your worthiness can't be an issue in this way, that you have to not think about these feelings of unworthiness. Any unworthiness feelings that you have need to be pushed aside, because they're saying that you have to come first in this way, and you can't spend time giving to others and pleasing to others and pleasing others. When it comes to this area that you have to heal yourself right now, and you have to focus on yourself a little bit right now. They're saying this is the time for you to just focus on you and to remove yourself from situations that are not really focused on you in the right way, where they are healing you or benefiting you, if they are causing this conflict with your healing. So if it's something that you have gone into or are attempting to do, which is really not out of your highest happiness or passion or what you would want to do, but it's out of this kind of abuse or neglect or whatever it was that was experienced in the childhood emotionally that they keep coming up with. But they're coming in with the word abuse, and especially emotional, I'm getting. Anything that you have, it's like you've pulled from that, from those negative experiences to bring into the present, and anything that you're doing now out of that energy, or attempting to do now out of that energy, they're saying has got to go. This needs to be like the final chapter in those behaviors. In doing things or attracting people and being around people and inviting people to be with you who are not in alignment with you or who negatively affect you. Okay, so that's basically the end of the reading, they're saying. They are showing me again the back with the crystals, and they're just pulling all these cords, like these cords are snapping off of the back area, and all of these ideas and things are breaking and shifting, they're saying, and that's what they're sending you right now. And they're also encouraging you. They are standing in a circle and they're applauding you. And then also they're showing me that you are zooming forward. So this is a time to remove this off of you, but you're also expanding and you're coming into your own. And they're saying that things are going to move much more quickly for a while because of this energy and the therapy that you're going to go through, or that they would want you to go through. So they are thanking me for doing this reading for you, and I thank you so much for allowing me to do this reading for you. And as always, I hope that it truly benefits you and that it helps you on your path in some way, in helping yourself and also in being of service to others. Thank you.